Ladies and gentlemen, it's my great pleasure to present you today a part of my PhD work on the development of a protocol for predicting the degradation of concrete during the winter period. It's a PhD thesis granted by ANRT under a CIFRE convention associating Association Technique de l'Industrie des Liens Hydrauliques to École Centrale de Nantes. In this presentation, we will begin with the internal and normative context, then we'll present the main problematic issue and the experimental campaign of Moins Égal in France. We'll present after that the laboratory campaign in GEM Laboratory in École Centrale de Nantes. We'll show the results and discuss them, and finally our perspectives in this work of PhD. About concrete pathologies, under severe exposure conditions, concrete suffers from various types of pathologies that penalize the operation of structures in bridges, highways, and dams, and the expected service conditions. Repair costs are enormous, and FRISO is one of the most penalizing exposure in Europe. Under this exposure, degradation can come in two forms. First, internal damage, which is a deterioration inside the mass of concrete, and then scaling, which is a superficial deterioration of the exposed surface. In order to ensure the longevity of the material, to increase its resistance to severe conditions, and to protect the consumer, a normative context has been developed, such as the work of CEN, ASTM, NF, and BNQ. Their main aim is to develop test methods in form of normative documents to assess the resistance of concrete. Regarding the characterization of the degradation of concrete exposed to FRISO cycles, the norms and standard consist of the following steps. After preparation of concrete samples by pouring and demolding after 24 hours, curing of the specimens according to each standard, exposure of concrete samples to temperature inside a climatic chamber for a certain time with a common range of plus 20, minus 20, and at the end, in order to elaborate a report of the results, some measurements has to be taken, such as the scaled masses, relative elongation, relative dynamic models, etc. Here's a photo that shows all these steps for the French norm XPP 18420. Our main interest is given to the thermal cycle that is applied during the test. Why? Because if we take the thermal cycle of the main testing methods that are used at the European scale, such as the CDF test, the slab test, and the cube test of the technical specification report 123909, and the thermal cycle of the French norm XPP 18420, we can see the differences in the thermal cycle parameters, such as the freezing rate, the thawing rate, the minimum and maximum temperatures, and the duration of the cycle itself. But for the natural mechanisms of actual damage and degradation to be active, the FRISO cycle applied in the lab must resemble to natural temperature variations. Otherwise, the test results obtained will be misleading and irrelevant due to lack of correlation and reliability between the lab test and the actual exposure conditions. Here we reached our problematic issue. It is therefore questionable whether these normative cycles, both with respect to minimum temperature, maximum temperature, and freezing and thawing rates, are too aggressive or not. In order to answer this question, a campaign was held in Moins Égal in France. Why Moins Égal? Because of its geographical characteristics. So it has a high altitude, there is a complete weather station there, so we have access to complete weather data, and it is located in a zone of moderate or severe frost zone according to NFEN 206.1. Here's the French map where the Moins Égal station is shown in yellow in a severe to moderate frost zone. So there we placed concrete blocks, two large concrete blocks used for temperature monitoring, and they are equipped with thermocouples on all sides, on all faces. And eight other concrete specimens were placed in order to monitor degradation. So scaling was measured on the surface of these blocks. All concrete blocks that are placed here are configured according to the slab test or the French norm. Here are two photos that showed our concrete blocks used for monitoring temperature in the winter season. We registered meteorological conditions in Moins Égal for the winter season 2019-2020. According to this observation, we can see the difference in the temperature profiles. So it's not regular, it's not symmetrical in comparison with the temperature cycle applied in the norm, and the FRISO cycles, when they appear, when they exist, they are generally of an amplitude of 10 degrees Celsius, never 40 degrees Celsius. So they are fluctuating from plus 5 to minus 5 and not from plus 20 to minus 20 like in the normative temperature cycles. As a conclusion of this campaign, the temperature curves of the concrete does not seem to be consistent with very regular and symmetrical temperature profile imposed by the different normative tests. The amplitude of the thermal cycles in the norms are of 40 degrees Celsius, whereas 10 degrees Celsius in real exposure. We decided to do our laboratory experimental campaign, and here's the experimental plan adopted. So after confection of cubes of 15 centimeters, we did demolding and cure in water until the age of 7, then a cure in air at 65 relative humidity, 65% relative humidity and 20 degrees Celsius was done. During this step, the sewing of the cubes in two was done. So we had two types of testing surface, either mold bottom face or sewn face. Some of the specimens continued the curing in air. The other part were cured at 65% relative humidity, 20 degrees Celsius, and a concentration of 3% of carbon dioxide. So this was continued until the age of 28 days, and then we did pre-saturation with a 3% NaCl solution until the age of 31 days, where the beginning of the freeze-thaw cycles. 16 specimens were used for lab tests under plus 20, minus 20 degrees Celsius of this lab test. And 8 specimens were placed in Moi Igual as shown before. Here's a photo that show our specimens inside the climatic chamber binder MKF 240 in Jean Laboratory in Ecole Centrale de Nantes, and the arrangement of thermocouples. So thermocouples were immersed in the saline solution at the top of the testing surface of the specimen, like shown in this photo, and we registered temperature profile over many cycles in the saline solution. About boundary conditions for the lab test, we applied 56 freeze-thaw cycles of plus 20, minus 20 according to this lab test. About the boundary condition in real exposure, so at Moi Igual site, we registered for the winter season 2019-2020 only 29 cycles ranging from plus 5 to minus 5. Regarding the results, first, the scaling results of the specimen placed in Moi Igual, so in real exposure conditions, are here. So the mold bottom face scaled more than the sewn face, such as of an average of scaled masses after 29 freeze-thaw cycles of plus 5, minus 5, we reached for the mold bottom face 10 gram per meter square. We asked barely 2 gram per meter square for sewn face. Maybe this is because the mold bottom face has a higher quantity of cement-based matrix that is able to scale than in sewn surface. About the results of the campaign of the laboratory, we decided to divide our study into two. First, we studied the effect of the type of cure for the same testing surface. So if we take the mold bottom face, we can see that the cure in CO2 has a negative effect on the scaling resistance of the material. So the specimen cured in CO2 scaled more than the specimen cured in air. It is not the same case in the case of sewn face, because the effect of the cure in CO2 is not pronounced after 56 cycles of freeze-thaw. So maybe this is because of the presence of aggregates that block the diffusion of CO2 in the material in case of sewn face. The second part of our study was to study the effect of the test surface for the same type of cure. So either for the cure in CO2 or the cure in air, we can see that the mold bottom face did more scaling than the sewn face. And the same result was found for the specimen placed in Moi Igual in real exposure conditions. To go further, we did a 3D mapping of the degraded test surfaces, or a profilometry. So even more, even though that the mold bottom face did more scaling than the sewn face, we can see that the sewn face, the depth of degradation in the case of the sewn face is higher for both type of curing and can reach 2.5 millimeter, and this can be related to some aggregates that are removed from the surface during the scaling phenomenon. So about this laboratory campaign, we can conclude the following. Concerning the choice of the test surface, the scaling results highlight the interest of carrying out the tests on the mold bottom surface and the difficulties in interpreting the test on the sewn side, which associate the degradation of aggregate shapes altered by sewing with the scaling phenomenon. Second thing is that if the scaling of concrete skin is important, we notice that the scaling of the inner part is weaker, which is positive for the global durability of the concrete. And so we can say that it will be sufficient to study the resistance of the mold bottom face to scaling, because once this surface is removed by scaling, the inner part, which is represented by the sewn face, will scale less. About the effect of the cure in CO2, we already know that aging is a mode of interaction with the environment that modifies the chemistry, the porosity, and mechanical properties of concrete. But a preconditioning period of 12 days with a carbon dioxide content of 3% did not reflect the effect of aging on the improvement of the free flow resistance. Maybe we needed more time. We finally characterized the mix before and after 56 free flow cycles of plus 20, minus 20. So we saw that for healthy molded test specimen, the depth of ingress of chloride ions in the specimen was equal to 2.8 centimeters. After 56 free flow cycles, the depth of ingress of chloride ions in the degraded core test specimen reached 4 centimeters, which is equal to the coating thickness. So we reached the air meter, which is dangerous. Even the porosity accessible to water was increased by 1.6%. So the degradation under the action of normative free flow cycles penalized the durability of the material by increasing its ability to be crossed by aggressive agents such as chlorides, and these chlorides can reach the air meter. As our perspective, we already saw that a new cycle should be proposed to replace the existing thermal cycle. This could be defined as a full amplitude of 10 to 15 degrees Celsius chosen on the basis of the real exposure conditions in countries with reputedly severe climates, a cooling rate that should probably not significantly exceed 2 degrees Celsius per hour, otherwise it will be much faster than the real cooling rate, and a thawing rate that should not probably be more than twice the freezing rate. So these ideas were present also in the perspectives of Jensen in 2002 in a conference in a RILEM conference. At the end, we will do comparison of the scaling results that will be obtained for each proposed thermal cycle with those that are obtained now by imposing the normative cycle of plus 20, minus 20 in terms of the level of degradation or scaling and reproducibility, because it's an important thing in normative tests. This is everything. Thank you for your attention, and it's my great pleasure to hear your comments and answer your questions.